Welcome to a second video on probability. The goal of this video is to determine the probability of different events. This video builds on what we learned from the introductory video on probability, and we'll also be using combinations to determine some of the probabilities. So just to review, the probability of an event compares the favorable number of outcomes to the total number of outcomes, and this can be expressed as a fraction, decimal, or percentage. Let's go and take a look at some examples. Here we're using a standard deck of cards, and for number one, we want to determine the probability of drawing two cards that are both face cards. Well, we're selecting two cards from the deck, so the total number of ways to select two cards from a deck would be 52 choose 2, and the total number of ways of selecting two face cards, well, there are 12 face cards in the deck, so that would be 12 choose 2. Remember, we can write this using different notation. For example, we can write 12 choose 2 over 52 choose 2. And I say that because we're going to go ahead and use the calculator to evaluate this. And the calculator uses this type of notation. Let's go ahead and evaluate this probability. So we have 12 choose 2, so 12 math probability option 3. And then we type in R, which was 2. That's 66, and we'll divide this by 52 choose 2. So 52 math probability option 3 and 2. Enter. So it's approximately 0.498. Now I do want to take a look at this problem in a second way. We don't have to use combinations. We could think of this as two events where the first event is selecting the first card and the second event is selecting the second card. And we could ask ourselves, what is the probability of selecting a face card as the first card? Well, there's 12 face cards out of 52 cards times the probability of selecting a face card a second time, given this is already a face card. Well, now there'd only be 51 cards, and there would also only be 11 face cards left. So we'd have 11 over 51 for the second probability. And this product will give us the same probability. Let's go ahead and check it. So we'll have 12 divided by 52 times 11 divided by 51. And as you see, the result is the same. So many times there's more than one way to find a given probability. So this is also a valid way to solve this probability question. Number two, the probability of drawing two cards that are both aces. Okay, so with the probability of two aces. Well, again, we're selecting two cards, so the total number of ways of selecting two cards is still going to be 52 choose 2, but there's only four aces in the deck, so the favorable number of ways of selecting two aces would be there's four aces, and we want to choose two at a time. And let's go ahead and use the calculator again to do this. So we have 4 choose 2. Divided by 52 choose 2. And we have approximately 0.0045. It should make sense that this probability is much less than number one, because here we have 12 face cards, and here we only have 4 aces. And again, the alternative approach would be to think of this as two different events. So we could multiply the probabilities together, where the first probability is the probability of selecting an ace on the first card, which would be 4 out of 52 times 3 out of 51. And again, this product would result in the same probability. Let's go and take a look at number 3. The probability of drawing 4 cards all of the same suit. Okay, so this one gets a little more interesting. The probability of selecting 4 cards of the same suit. Let's first consider the denominator. Well, we're selecting 4 cards now, so the denominator would be 52 choose 4. Remember, in all these, we're using combinations because the order doesn't matter. If the order did matter, we'd be using permutations. Now, the numerator, we want to have 4 cards of the same suit. Well, each suit contains 13 cards. So part of the favorable number of ways would be 13 choose 4. However, there are four different suits to choose from. So we would have, so this would actually be 4 times 13 choose 4. Again, remember the first card could be any of the four suits. Therefore, we have 4 times as many ways to have a favorable outcome. Let's go ahead and determine what this would be, and we'll take a look at this one a different way as well. The numerator would be 4 times 13 choose 4, and we're going to divide this by 52 choose 4. This comes out to approximately 0106. Again, let's take a look at an alternative approach. We're drawing 4 cards, 1, 2, 3, 4, and let's consider each card individually. This first card can actually be any card as long as the other 3 cards are of the same suit. So the probability of selecting the first card correctly would be 52 out of 52. However, for the second card, whatever suit this is, this one must match it. So there's one less card, and whatever suit this is, there's going to be one less of that suit to select from. So there would be 12 instead of 13 left in that suit. And then from there, the total number of cards drops by 1, and so does the number of cards in that suit. This would be 11 over 50, this would be 49, and this would drop from 11 to 10. Let's go and make sure this product is the same as what we have over here with the combinations. Well, the first fraction is 1, then we have 12 divided by 51, and then we have 11 divided by 50, and 10 divided by 49. And as you can see, the result is the same. So this just emphasizes you often have more than one way to find a given probability. Let's see if we have time for some more questions. A group of 10 students made up of 6 females and 4 males form a committee of 4. What is the probability the committee is all male? Well, the total number of outcomes would be the number of ways we can select a committee of 4 from a group of 10. That would be 10 choose 4. The favorable ways of selecting an all-male committee, well, there's 4 males, so we'd have 4 choose 4 in our numerator. Let's go to the calculator. Well, 4 choose 4 is equal to 1, so I'll have 1 divided by 10 choose 4. So the probability is approximately 0.0048 to have a committee of all males. Number 2, what is the probability the committee will be all female? Well, it's similar process. Here we have the probability of all females. We're still selecting 4 from a group of 10. So our denominator is 10 choose 4. Now the favorable number of ways of selecting females, since there's 6 females, we have 6 choose 4. Let's see what this would be. We have 6 choose 4 divided by 10 choose 4. And you can see it is higher because there are more females to select from. It's approximately 0.0714. Okay, on this question here, it says, what is the probability the committee is made up of 2 females and 2 males? Well, our denominator is still going to be 10 choose 4. But the number of ways of selecting 2 females, if there's 6 to select from, that would be 6 choose 2 times the number of ways to select 2 males. And there are 4 males to select from, so that would be 4 choose 2. So the total number of ways of selecting the 2 females times the total number of ways of selecting the males divided by the total number of ways to select the entire committee would give us the desired probability. Let's go back to the calculator. Here our numerator would be 6 choose 2 times 4 choose 2. So there's our numerator. And we'll divide by 10 choose 4. And there we have it, approximately 0.4286. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found the explanations helpful.